On March 16th, 2024, at 10:22 p.m. local time, a bright orange glow lit up the night sky in southwestern Iceland. A new volcanic eruption had just begun, and just like I had suggested might eventually occur in an earlier video, it was preceded by only a negligible number of earthquakes. In other words, this volcanic eruption almost completely began without warning, with only 11 microquakes striking in the preceding 61 minutes. Thankfully, the eruption did not harm anyone and is taking place in an area where the potential did not exist for a person to be unexpectedly caught off guard. The eruption is occurring via a lengthy southwest trending fissure which quickly unzipped to 2,900 meters in length. Within 10 minutes of the eruption onset, tens of thousands of people on the Reykjanes Peninsula were able to witness the tallest lava fountains Iceland has experienced in 51 years. Due to what I am assuming was a higher than typical gas content in the erupting magma, it was propelled upwards to such an extent that certain lava fountains reached 275 meters or 900 feet in height. This is a truly stunning figure, and I currently estimate around 310 cubic meters per second of lava to be actively erupting. Basaltic lava flows from this completely effusive eruption are currently flowing in several directions, but the most concerning is the advancing lobe moving in the direction of Grindavik. This two-pronged flow is likely to diverge to the southwest, with one prong heading towards Grindavik's town center, while the other prong flows to the south. Thankfully, due to it taking longer than expected, which in the case was 36 days for an eruption to occur, there was sufficient time to build a series of lava barriers around Grindavík, the Svartsengi geothermal power plant, and a NATO facility. These barriers, which stretch for 11.4 kilometers in length and are up to 8 meters or 26 feet in height, have during the past three eruptions proven quite effective. I suspect that a third lobe will move towards the Svartsengi geothermal power plant, but here is why I am not too concerned. I could almost call the current ongoing eruption as a sort of jack-of-all-trades, master-of-none type eruption. No singular lava flow appears to be dominant, meaning that although lava flows are advancing towards three critical points of infrastructure, they are unlikely to reach any single one of them. And if they do, because this eruption is unexpectedly longer than anticipated, the thin lava flows will be unlikely to break the existing lava barriers. Just like the last three eruptions, which occurred at a rate of one a month, I fully expect the current Icelandic-style eruption to last for less than 72 hours in length. There simply is not a large enough supply of underlying shallow magma to feed an eruption for longer than that time span. As tens of thousands of people tune in to the several spectacular live streams, individuals will be able to witness the natural progression of an Icelandic eruption, which is as follows. A fissure unzips and expands in length while erupting towering fountains of lava along its entire length. These lava fountains slowly decrease in height, eventually no longer forming a continuous mass. Several small dominant vents then form along the fissure, sucking magma away from what would have erupted further away into a concentrated area, creating several spatter cones. As magma supply continues to decrease, the expanding lava flow reaches its longest extent around 12 hours later. A single dominant vent then remains, which slowly but surely declines in intensity. That is, until the magma output drops below 3 cubic meters per second and the eruption ends. Do you have any additional questions about this current eruption? Be sure to let me know in the comments section below. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.